Hello everyone, welcome to this video session on primary and secondary memory. I am Sandeep Saxena. In today's video we will discuss about the primary memory and the secondary memory in a computer system or in a system. When we say the word system, that means that we are talking about something which has a processor, which has a memory, which has a hard disk. So today we will differentiate what primary memory, what is secondary memory, what is hard disk, what is RAM, etc. So let's start with the primary memory. So when we say the word primary memory, then and if I say main memory, or I say RAM, or I say memory, these all are same things. When we talk about a system and we say the word memory, then we obviously talking about the RAM or the primary memory or the main memory. So these all terms are same, so please don't get confused about these terms. So now I'm just showing you the RAM, how it looks like. So many of you has seen this in your computer systems when you disassemble them. So RAM is called as primary memory because it is directly connected to the processor's address bus and data bus. That's why this memory is called as the primary memory, because only this memory can talk to the processor, or we can say directly it can talk to the processor. And where does our program code executes? Obviously it is executes in RAM. For those information you can watch my other videos in which I have explained about the address space and all. So I hope the concept of RAM or primary memory or the main memory has been clear to you. So if you want more detail about how a program get executed in a system, then you can request or you can directly email me so that I will make that video. For now it is just for the understanding purpose that what RAM is, what primary memory is, or what main memory is. Now we will talk about the secondary memory. So we all know that secondary memory, we have heard many times, hard disk, memory cards, flash memories and SSDs. Yes, these are the secondary memory because these are not connected to the processor directly. Also these are the storage devices. So if we use the word memory, then it is right also, but when we explicitly say a memory of a system, then we obviously talking about the RAM, not about the secondary memory. So if you are an embedded engineer or something like that, then you must understand the concept of primary memory, because when we say the word memory, we always talk about the RAM, we always talk about the primary memory. These are the storage devices which comes in the class of secondary memory, and these are not directly connected to the processor. These are connected with the processor through the RAM. In the RAM, lies in the address space region of the processor, and this is just a peripheral for that particular system, and peripheral comes in the address space region. So somewhere it is connected there in the RAM, or you can say in the address space. So we access them to store our data, we access them to flash an OS or something. In the flash memory of a microcontroller, we usually flash our firmware code and all. So such memory is called as the secondary memory. But code always executes in RAM, not in the secondary memory. It just stores our executables, or you can say our data, multimedia data, or anything. So these are the types of the secondary memory: hard disk, memory cards, flash memory, SSDs. Hard disk, we all have examples of hard disk in our laptop or the CPUs and other things. Memory cards are also secondary memory, and so many of you guys have heard about Raspberry Pi and other be like computers, small pocket computers like BeagleBone Black and all these are booted from the memory cards. And flash memory, I have already explained that it comes into the picture of the in the case of microcontrollers, and SSDs are also the flash memory. So these are the types of the secondary memory. This is the disassembled view of the hard disk, and this is the laptop's hard disk. I hope you guys have seen these things. Now another memory which you have heard about is the cache memory. This comes into picture to speed up the processor or to speed up the system, because this memory is used to store the data which should be fetched to the processor directly, or which should be fetched to the processor very frequently. So this memory is called as the cache memory. This is inside the processor, this is not outside the processor. Till now we have talked about the memory which was outside the processor, but this memory lies inside the processor. So guys, thank you for watching.